when you first hear something is unbreakable and indestructible, your first sense is automatically skepticism. You know, having the experience that I have in the sport and going through as many sticks as I have and seeing all the gimmicks about how you can repair them and this is a protector and that kind of thing, of course, you know, I was a little bit skeptic at first, but after using it and I've been using sticks for months and not even seeing a crack or a chip, you know, that's gone. Like, no skepticism anymore.
So basically the Colt hockey stick is an intersection between technology and composite hockey sticks. What we've done is we've used a pro stock composite. It's built to the same specifications as a pro stock. And we've engineered it with a patented nano material, which allows for increased strength and durability. A lot of my friends got into ball hockey when they finished playing. And what I noticed was in ball hockey, it's a much more hack and slash type of game. So what that meant that meaning was that all my friends were going through about three sticks a week, which is very, very terrible on the pocket, especially considering that many of the purchases are between $200 and $300 per stick. We were able to put it into professional hockey players and junior A players' hands, and that's when they had some fun with it. They were taking, we had people logging 1,000 slap shots per hour on this thing, and we did not experience any damage or any deadening of the shaft, which is what happens with a lot of the composites. What you'll have is after a considerable amount of hours, you'll notice that the flex and the pop in the shaft itself deteriorates completely, and you almost have a dead stick. So even though on some of the sticks, the initial testing, we logged over 10,000 hours between players, and we did not experience any deadening of the shaft whatsoever, which we were able to back up with lab testing again, with the flex testing and impact testing. The strength held up and so did the durability. We've had interest from a handful of NHLers, about seven to date. The problem obviously is their specifications are very, very detailed. So until we're ready with the final product, which will be in the next few weeks, we don't want to hand them out just yet, but we're hoping by mid-December we can fulfill the orders and the desires of all the NHL players who have had interest, because it does benefit them as well, right? No player, whether you're a recreational or an NHL player, wants to go mid-game and when the team is relying on you, missing a big opportunity because of a broken stick. So we sought out on a mission to come up with a solution to fix composites, since they were snapping way too easily and they cost way too much money. So what ended up happening was, after countless iterations, we stumbled upon a company called Integran Technologies, who create these nanomaterials, and they have applications in aerospace and medical devices. So it's very, very sophisticated materials. We presented our idea for a hockey stick, and after months and months of prototyping, we've actually just about ready to start production on the first Colt hockey stick. This ping pong ball, which is coated with the same metal that is seen on the Colt itself. The ping pong ball is just a standard ping pong ball. It added about 4 to 6 grams of weight to the ping pong ball through the coating. And the benefit of this ping pong ball, as you'll see, is it's strong enough to actually stand on, which I'll show you now. This is just a typical ping pong ball coated in the nano material. But as you can see, I can put all of my weight onto it. And then when we get it back, no damage whatsoever can be seen on the ball itself. So as soon as we saw this, we figured if they can do this to a ping pong ball, they can probably do it to a hockey stick, which is what began the process altogether. So what we've done is we've put the same material over the hockey stick itself in the hack zone, and it's very, very thin application of the metal itself, but it adds tremendous strength and durability.
All right, now I got a regular composite in my hand, so I'm gonna try to break this the same way I tried the Colt. So first I'm gonna start over the crossbar. If it doesn't fail, we're going to the post.